Hey guys, it's your Arzu, and to review the LEGO Star Wars Rebels, the Phantom 2.0. But yeah, so this is the box here. So you see, it's recommended for just 7 Craft, and this set 75170, and comes with prefigures, which are Chopper, Grand Admiral Kron, and also Kanan. So yeah, and see, those have a pretty nice box art, and you got the Death Trooper on the corner there. And yeah, so this is the top of the box showing you the actual size. And yeah, this is the side just showing you the same thing at the front, and nothing on the other side or the bottom. But yeah, so the back shows you all the features and master the force. And yeah, but aside from that, that's it for the box. So this is the instruction manual here, and you know, just a pretty basic one. You just have numbered bags, the first page, and this is the final page right here. And yeah, so you see, you got the rest of the sets for the winter wave of 2017. And yeah, you also have this minifigure checklist. And yeah, it's pretty cool. And you also have this poster type thing. And you have LEGO Life. And you have all the parts list. And yeah, but aside from that, that's it for the instructions. So these are the extra pieces here. So you see, comes with an extra spring-loaded missile. And yeah, so you have this lightsaber hilt, and you have two of these Technic pieces, and you got this tile, and also this black stud, and also this printed tile, which is a thermal detonator. And yeah, that's pretty nice to get. And finally, you have this extra Grand Admiral Kron's face. For some reason, I'm not sure, most likely an error. This is definitely not on purpose. They won't put an extra minifigure head in these sets. So yeah, but still nice to get. And yeah, but that's it for the extra pieces. So the first figure here is Chopper. So yeah, you can see he has his droid hit mode, and yeah, you got its eyes, and here you got all the linings and stuff like that. And yeah, it's a little bit wonky, but yeah, that's normal for LEGO droid figures. And yeah, but you can see you have all the detailing here, and the top you have the white line. And yeah, so the kind of torso part, I guess, has its arm, and also, you know, all the mechanical stuff. And yeah, you can move him around just like a normal astromech. And the bottom does have a tile piece. And yeah, but aside from that, that's it for Chopper. So the second figure here is Grand Admiral Kron. So yeah, you see he's armed with his blaster here, and yeah, he got his nice blue hair piece. And yeah, so his face here, this is just his calm expression. And yeah, it looks nice. I like the blue skin tone. And the torso printing here, you got the ranking thing here, and you got these pen style thing on both sides. And you got the belt, no leg printing, just like a normal officer. And yeah, so this is the back. You just have the continuation for the belt printing. And yeah, just this lining, two of them. And does have his alternate expression, which is this. So this is his angry expression. And yeah, but aside from that, that's it for an Admiral Kron. Last but not least, this is Kanan. So yeah, he's armed with his lightsaber with the blue blade, and yeah, it's pretty nice to get. And yeah, so you can see his hairpiece is a dual molded piece, I believe. And yeah, he has his blindfold thing on, and yeah, it does look pretty cool. And if you remove that, you can see you got just his calm face. And yeah, so the torso printing, you have his green shirt, and you have his belt right there, and you know, have some does have some equipment on there. And you have this line thing. I'm not sure what's with all the arrow stuff on the Star Wars things. And yeah, but the leg print thing, you can see he does have a holster and also a knee pad type thing. And yeah, so the back here, you can see he got his kind of smiling expression. And the back torso printing, you just have this belt, and yeah, just some printing for his torso. But aside from that, that's it for Kanan. So this is the build itself here. So let's start with the cockpit. So the cockpit, you have crew stickers, and yeah, so you have this arrow sticker, which yeah, I'm again not sure what it is, but you also have two of these yellow stickers, which are there just to make it look more accurate. And the canopy piece, they actually used the Speed Champions piece, so that's a very nice use of it. And yeah, does look pretty nice. And inside the cockpit, you have this printed console piece, which is a very common one, and also just a seat in there so that you can put in Kanan. And yeah, he just sits on that thing, and yeah, no studs or anything, so that's much more easier to take the figure out. And this thing is actually removable, which I'm not sure why, but yeah, I guess it could be an escape pod or something. But yeah, so the back, you have this little part here, which is the place where you can put in Chopper. And yeah, if you see, this thing is actually not in the middle. That's because it is not in the middle in the show. And yeah, I'm not sure why, but yeah, it's just like that. But you can see there's two of these spring-loaded missiles, which I'll show you how you can fire it later. But yeah, so you got these landing gears right here, which yeah, actually they are not really balanced at all, because like the back here is actually like closer to the ground, and the front one here is a little bit further from the ground. So yeah, it just makes this entire thing just unbalanced, I guess. And yeah, it just doesn't look so great. So yeah, that kind of sucks. And yeah, so you have just the slope piece right here, and the landing gear, you can actually recrack them because they are on ratcheted pieces, so you can just push them in pretty easily. They are visible though, but yeah, what can you do about it? And you can just close it in. And yeah, so the top here, you got this big fin piece, and you got all these big sticker pieces. And yeah, like if you don't stick them on there, yeah, this thing will just look very plain. So yeah, these are very important stickers. And you also have this stripe right here to make this look. And yeah, this is not sure what the symbol is supposed to be, but yeah. And it's on both sides as well. And yeah, so they actually used the pretty nice technique for this this fin piece right here. And yeah, they actually just connected using these Technica beam pieces. And yeah, so I'll just close it back up. And yeah, so the back, you have this hatch thing. And yeah, so You got the sticker piece right here, which I'm not sure what this is, but you can open it up and you can see inside you have a crate. I'll show you what's inside later, but yeah, you also have this yellow thing, which is the trigger for the spring-loaded shooter, so you can just fire it like that. And yeah, so this part right here is supposed to be the engine cluster for the thing in the show. So yeah, I'm not sure why they didn't include that, or at least added a sticker on it to make it look more real, I guess. But yeah, so inside you just have a tile piece in there, and you can't actually put anything, any figure in there. You can just only put some cargo, but yeah, you can stuck a figure in there, but yeah, the figure won't be sitting on very nicely. But yeah, so this crate right here is just a Imperial crate type thing, so you can just open it up. This is actually a sticker, but yeah, inside you have a thermo detonator, and you can you know, put the lightsaber, Kanan's lightsaber in there, so that yeah, you can carry everything with you in there. So yeah, that's great, except for Kron though. But yeah, so yeah, it does kind of suck that you can only fit a crate in there and not a figure. So yeah, but aside from that, that's it. So overall conclusion of this set, so how did I think of it? Well, the figures, I think they are probably the best part about the set. Chopper, you can get him in a few other sets, but yeah, it's still nice to get him because I don't have him. And Kron and Kanan is exclusive to the set, and yeah, I think they are both great. Yeah, Kron has some pretty nice detailing, and yeah, I like the new headpiece for him, and I like Kanan's dual molded hair piece, and yeah, it looks pretty good. So the build itself, I think it is actually good as well. Just that there are a few downsides to it, and yeah, that is the landing gear. They are not balanced, and also the back, you can't fit any figure inside, and also you don't have any cluster detailing. But yeah, those are just small complaints. But yeah, I like how they integrated these spring-loaded missile in there, and also how I like all the building techniques. And yeah, like this thing does look good. It's just that the price for the set is I just feel that it's a little overpriced, and you know, like what you get here is just feels not enough, because Kron, maybe they could have included a side build, then yeah, it would have made the set like feel more worth it, or maybe they could have added in more pieces, then yeah, I would have been more satisfied with the set. But yeah, I think it's actually just there are too many small pieces in the set, I guess, probably the reason why this thing feels a little bit too small. But yeah, still, I think the set is pretty cool. But yeah, maybe you just get it on when they have sale for the set or something. But still, overall, I think the set is great, and yeah, I'll recommend you getting it. So, buying some of the set down in the description box below, along with all my social media pages down in the description. So, if you like my channel, make sure to subscribe right here and watch more videos right here. So, that's it for the video. Thanks for watching, and I'll